Like millions of my fellow citizens, I was shaken by the attack on the Capitol on January 6th and on our democracy more broadly by your predecessor and his followers. While I appreciate efforts being made to bring them to justice, I worry about ongoing threats to our country from Americans who embrace white supremacy and conspiracies that align with it. What can your administration do to address this complex and wide-ranging problem?
It's complex, it's wide-ranging, and it's real. I got involved in politics to begin with because of civil rights and opposition to white supremacists, the Ku Klux Klan, and the most dangerous people in America continue to exist. That is the greatest threat to terror in America, domestic terror. And so I would make sure that my Justice Department and the Civil Rights Division is focused heavily on those very folks. And I would make sure that we, in fact, focus on how to deal with the rise of white supremacy. And you see what's happening, the studies that are beginning to be done, maybe at your university as well, about the impact of former military, former police officers on the growth of white supremacy in some of these groups. You may remember in one of my debates with the former president, I asked him to condemn the Proud Boys. He wouldn't do it. He said, stand by, stand ready, or whatever the phrase exactly was. It is a bane on our existence. It has always been, as Lincoln said, we have to appeal to our better angels. And these guys are not, and women are in fact demented. They are dangerous people.